Hello everyone. So welcome back to Offices class. Now in today's class, I am going to continue with the revision of your unit test exam. And the next chapter which I want to start with the revision is light chapter. Okay, a very important chapter, that is light. So first of all, we should know what is light energy. So light is a form of energy which enables us to see, and it travels in a straight line. So light is, it is a form of energy which enables us to see. So because of the light energy, we can see the objects near around us, and the light energy, it travels in a straight line. That is known as rectilinear propagation of light, a property of light due to which it travels in a straight line. Then when we talk about the speed of light is near about 3 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. That is in vacuum. So in vacuum, the speed of light is maximum, and it reduces in different you can say that it reduces in different mediums. Like in air, it is actually near about 2.99 into 10 raised to power 8 meter per second. In glass or in different solids, the ray speed of light decreases. So speed of light is maximum in vacuum. So we should know in which medium the speed of light is maximum. So the speed of light is actually maximum in vacuum. Then afterwards, another topic is about reflection of light. So we should know what is reflection of light. The bouncing back of light into the same medium in which it was incident after striking a surface is called incident reflection of light. Suppose the ray of light is coming from a bulb. Okay, one bulb is there which is known as the source of light, and ray of light is coming from the bulb and it will strike on the surface. So after striking on the surface, the light energy will reflect back. It will return back, that is bouncing back. So the ray of light will going to bounce back into the same medium from which it was coming. And this bouncing back of light is known as reflection of light. Now reflection of light can be of two types. One is a regular reflection and another one is a diffused reflection, that is known as irregular reflection. So what is regular reflection? Now suppose if parallel rays of light are coming, that is incident rays are parallel to each other, and they all are coming and striking on this smooth surface. So whenever a parallel beam of light, which is incident ray, are striking on a smooth polished surface, and after striking it bounces back, and when it bounces back, the reflection or the reflected rays are also parallel to each other. In such a condition, you can say it is a regular reflection. Like suppose mirror is there. So if the rays of light which are incident on this smooth surface, when we are going to reflect back, they will going to reflect back with the same angle, and all the parallel rays of light which was inclined on the smooth surface, they will going to return back parallel to each other. So such kind of reflection is known as regular reflection. Whenever you see a good image forming on a mirror, that is because of the regular reflection. Then what is irregular reflection? That is also known as diffused reflection. So if any irregular surface is there, okay, that is a rough surface. Okay, so if any rough surface is there and a parallel rays of light, a parallel beam of light which is coming and they are going to striking on this smooth surface, they will also going to get reflected back, but this time they are reflecting in different directions. That is, they are getting scattered in different directions. So such kind of reflection is known as irregular or diffused reflection. So this kind of reflection generally you can see in walls, okay, you can see on the ground, which is a rough surface. So over there the same type of reflection takes place, and this reflection is also very important. Because of this diffused reflection, it is easier for us to see the things around, because whatever the things which we can see around is, they are basically irregular surface, that is rough surface, and they are scattering the light in different directions. So from different directions we can see the objects easily. So that is importance of irregular or diffused reflection. Now the next thing is about related terms related to reflection of light. So suppose one mirror is there. There is a mirror M M dash. Okay, this is a mirror, and a ray of light is coming and is striking on this smooth surface that is on the mirror. So after striking, it will be going to reflect back. Okay. So when it is striking and when it is reflecting back, the rays are there. The ray of light. The first term you should know is incident ray. So the ray of light, which is coming from the source and striking or basically hitting the point on the smooth surface that is on the mirror, this ray is known as incident ray. So the ray of light, which is initially coming from a source and striking on the mirror, this light, ray of light will be known as incident ray. Then second term is reflected ray. The ray of light which bounces back after striking the smooth or polished surface, or that is the mirror. So this ray of light which is reflecting back, or that is bouncing back, is known as reflected ray. So first term is incident ray, second term is reflected ray. Then a very important term is then normal. So what is normal? A perpendicular line drawn over the mirror. Okay, an imaginary line, and that is actually imaginary, and there is no such kind of line actually exists. This is only an imaginary line. This imaginary line, which is perpendicular to the surface or to the mirror, this perpendicular imaginary line is known as normal. Then a very important term, another term is there, point of incidence. Point of incidence, that is O point. This point is known as point of incidence. So what is point of incidence? The point over which the incident ray is striking. So one incident ray is coming from the source and it is going to strike on the surface, and this particular point where the incident ray will going to strike, that will be known as the point of incidence. Now the next is I means angle of incidence. So what is angle of incidence? The angle between the normal and the incident ray. So there is a normal and incident ray. So you can see this is the normal line and this is the incident ray. So the angle between this normal and the incident ray, this angle is known as angle of incidence, which is denoted by angle I, like this. Similarly, there is an angle between the reflected ray and the normal also. This is a reflected ray and this is a normal. And the angle between the reflected ray and normal is generally known as angle of reflection, that is angle R. So these are few common terms which you should know, which are related to reflection of light. First thing is the normal, incident ray, reflected ray, point of incidence, angle of incidence, and angle of reflection. So these terms and their meaning, their definitions, you should remember. Now, since we know different terms which are related to reflection of light, so we should now know what is laws of reflection. So suppose a mirror is there, which is a smooth surface, and incident ray is coming and striking on this smooth surface. So this incident ray will going to reflect back. Okay, so when it is reflecting back, it is following a law. So let us see which law it is following. The first law of reflection says that the angle of incidence is always equal to the angle of reflection. So suppose we are taking a plane mirror and incident ray is striking and it is reflected back. This is reflected ray and there is a normal line. So there is one angle of incidence and there is one angle of reflection. So the first law says that angle of incidence is always equal to angle of reflection. So if the ray of light is striking at an angle of 40 degree, so it should reflect back with the same angle, that is equals to 40 degree. So this is the first law of reflection. So we should follow this laws while drawing the ray diagrams whenever required. And the second one, the second law states that the incident ray, the reflected ray, and the normal. So this is the incident ray, this is the reflected ray, and this is a normal at the point of incidence. And they all are meeting at the point of incidence. All lie in the same plane and they all will going to lie on the same plane, means same piece of paper or whichever plane you are using, it should be turned in the same plane. So this is the second law of reflection. So these two laws, which are very, very important, which we have to use whenever we have to draw the ray diagrams that will be used in higher classes. So we should first remember these two laws, which are related to law of reflection, which will going to help us for making the laws, for making the reflection of light energy. Now after that, we should know about mirrors. We generally use mirror in our day-to-day life, and we all have seen mirrors, so we should know what is mirror. Mirror are the best reflector of light. So basically what happens, we have to take a glass sheet, a thin glass sheet, which should be transparent, and it is coated with silver color from one side so that no ray of light can pass through that particular glass sheet. So when no rays of light is passing, it will all going to reflect back, and then it will behave like a mirror. So a good mirror must have following properties. So if you want to have a mirror, what is good mirror, you should know. So the good mirror should have these following properties. First one, it must give maximum reflection. That means all the rays of light which are striking on the mirror, it should all get reflected back. It should not absorb any light. So if all the light rays are reflecting, that means no light rays should be absorbed. That is why it is coated with silver color, because silver color is, you can say it is a good reflecting color, and it is good, and it is a shiny color. So because of this shiny color and luster properties there, that is why we use silver color. Third one, it should not transmit any light. So no light should pass through a mirror. So if light energy will going to pass through a mirror, then image which is forming on the mirror will not be so clear. So these are the properties which a mirror should follow, then it will behave like a good mirror. Then basically two types of mirrors are there. Generally, the first kind of mirror is known as plane mirror, which we use in our daily life, and second type of mirror is known as a curved mirror. So in your syllabus, generally a plane mirror is there, and we should know all the uses, all the properties of plane mirror, that whenever you use a plane mirror and you stand in front of the plane mirror, some characteristics properties are there which you should know. Like suppose the first one, whenever you are standing in front of the plane mirror, the height of the object and height of the image which is forming inside the mirror are actually equal. So if a person of 5 feet is standing in front of the mirror, the image which is forming on the other side, that height of that image will also be equals to 5 feet. Then second thing, the distance of the object from the mirror, if you're standing at a distance of 2 meters, then the image which is forming on the mirror, that will also be standing at a distance of 2 meters from the mirror. Then third one, that is laterally inverted. This definition you should also know, what is lateral inversion. It is a property in which when you raise your right hand in front of the mirror, you find that your image is raising its left hand. So the right side of object appears to be left hand side in the image, and the left side of the object appears to be right hand side in the mirror. So this inversion of light, of image actually, is known as lateral inversion, and this is also a very important property which you can see in case of plane mirror. Then the object, if it is upright means the head is towards the top and your feet is towards the bottom, then in the same case the object will also, the image will also appear in the same manner, that the top will appear at upright, means the top will appear at top, that means the head will appear towards the top and the legs or the feet will going to appear towards the bottom. So that is the upright properties also there. So there are few properties which a mirror always carries, that is about the plane mirror. Then about the uses of plane mirror. So basically there are various kind of uses of plane mirror. Some of them I want to discuss over here. First of all, mirrors are used as looking glasses. So in our day-to-day life, we generally use mirror as a looking glasses, where you can see your face while combing, while brushing your teeth, in any of the cases. Then mirrors are used to provide false dimension to a, okay. So how it is used as a, to forming a false dimension. So suppose if a shop is there, a very small shop is there, and in that case, you want that shop to look or appear bigger in size. So what happens? Then in that situation, those mirrors are used, which are placed throughout in the inside the shop everywhere, so that the dimension appears to be bigger, that the size of your shop appears to be bigger. Then mirror are used in periscope, kaleidoscope, so different instruments are there in which mirrors are used. Then they are used in showcases that display jewelry and wrist watches. So in jewelry shops and wrist watch shops, you can find that mirrors are placed in the showcases. So these are some important uses of plane mirror. Then we should know the different types of colors of light. So generally there are some colors of light we should know. First type of light rays, which is known as a primary color. Primary color of light is basically red, green and blue. Then the combination of some rays, some colors will be there, where two primary colors will combine to form a single secondary color. So another color is there, secondary color. So primary colors, the colors which cannot be formed by mixing any other color. So basically they are basic colors which is not formed by mixing any other colors. They are known as primary colors, and they are red color, green color and blue color. Whereas another type of colors are there, another set of colors are there, the colors that are produced by mixing any two primary colors. So two primary colors or three primary colors, when they are mixed together and a new type of a color is formed, then it is said to be secondary colors. Like suppose red plus green, when it is combined, it will form yellow color. Blue plus green, when it will combine, it will form cyan color. Then red plus blue, when it will combine, it will form magenta color. And then when red plus green plus blue, it will going to combine, they will give you white color. So this is the combination of different colors. Then you can see different shades which we can see in our day-to-day life. So this is about colors which you people have to know.